We're back, and this time we've got a classic World War II style showdown between an American Strat and a Japanese Strat. We get this question all the time, don't we?
We do, and first of all, we are peaceful people, so we don't condone any sort of wars.
Yeah, absolutely.
But anyway, when it comes to guitars, bring it on. beat the shit out of each other with them.
That's it, we're always arguing all in right. the shop about these things.
Because this is a pretty contentious thing. People who love Japanese Strats really love Japanese Strats. Yep. And are like, you know, Japanese Strats are great, don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
But there's like a samurai mystique. This is forged by a dude, an old guy in a cave somewhere, and the Japanese have all the secrets to
things. The craftsmanship.
And so the Japanese people are gonna be like, "You are such a dick."
Yeah. But it is a bit of a thing.
But there's a real mystique around Japanese guitars.
Yeah. Right? And people that really love like Japanese Strats and like, you know, old Fender Japan stuff kind of tend to poo-poo on modern American 100% stuff.
Yeah. So, you know, and that's kind of the thing. And I love them both, so don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that they're not both great guitars, but they're different.
Yeah. These are known for like being great bang for buck, aren't they?
Yeah.
But recently they've kind of come up in price. So this is a hybrid 2 made in Japan Strat. And then we also have
the American Pro 2.
Yeah. So, but the price difference is like only a couple of $100.
Oh, no. This is streeting for about $1,700 Australian dollars.
Yeah.
Currently in what are we? Yeah, in 2021. And then
22,
that's
yeah.
2,500 bucks.
Yeah.
Depends on how good you are at turning the screws when you come into our shop. But, you know,
so it's a bit of a jump.
Yeah, there's a difference. Yeah. But you do get get a hard case with that guy. It's just $200. And you get a basic gig bag, which is $20.
Yeah.
Not poo-pooing the gig bag that it comes in, but it's crap.
So
Fender, come on, lift your game.
Yeah.
Yep. Seriously.
Need a flight case.
Like, I mean, look at the bag it came in.
It's pretty bog standard.
I'll hold it up. It's okay, I guess.
My lunch. But I think Mexican ones
come in a better bag than that.
Yeah, it's not very good.
If they come in bags, some of that come in bags. But you know what I'm saying? Like, come on.
We're hoping that this video is gonna give some guidance to which one to buy. You're obsessed with the team. All right, we're off target. Yeah, we're hoping this video is going to give you some guidance as to, you know, which one to pick. And is it worth spending the extra couple of $100?
So let's say 30% more.
Yeah, on one of these.
Yeah.
So should we go through, which one should we go through first?
Start with the Japanese one.
Yeah.
Because it is cool.
All right, well, as I said earlier, this is the Hybrid 2 Fender Japan Stratocaster. Outer body. Maple neck.
Yep.
Obviously maple fretboard.
You get maple or rosewood, whichever, but
yeah.
And modern C neck.
Yep.
Which feels great. I mean, like, yeah, it's a great feeling neck.
Yeah. And the modern C is like the same as like most Fenders of late until this one came out, which is the deep C, right?
Yeah.
So you've also got the custom voiced hybrid 2 pickups, which are nice.
Yeah. They sound good. The 2-point trim and vintage style saddles. I mean, I'm not going to go through the fact that it's got a 5-way switch, but vintage style machine heads, which you can get a shot of later on. But you know, sort of vintage style machine heads.
Narrow tall frets. But another thing is, this apparently also has narrow tall frets, and these frets definitely feel bigger than those frets do.
They look meatier.
Yeah. But that's kind of weird.
That's it.
And a
gig bag, which I don't like.
Yeah. But it's like one time Strat, basically. You know, like if you were thinking of a Strat, if you closed your eyes and thought of a Strat, that's it.
This screams a lot of colour of this one. This is called Medina Red, which I think looks great. It's from Mark Knopflerish, which is obviously not Medina Red, but like, you know, it's got that thing about it.
Yeah.
It's cool.
It's pretty good. All right, and then this is the American Pro 2, and basically this one features all the new modern updates, doesn't it?
Yep, so the new V-Mod pickups, V-Mod 2s, I think, in now.
Yep.
I mean, you've still got a two-point trim, you've still got the vintage-style saddles.
This trim's actually different to that one, because this has a cold-rolled steel block in it.
I can't see that, can I?
Yeah, so it should technically be more resonant as a bridge. Then you got, obviously, the same kind of controls, but you've got a little push-pull on the second tone,
which adds
the neck to positions one and two, apparently, so you can get some other flavors in there. Then, outer body or roasted pine on some particular colors, but this one's outer, I believe. And then what else have we got?
Carved heel.
They took
that from the Fender Ultra.
Probably the most noticeable difference. Deep C neck with...
Which is not chunky. Like,
feels kind of the same.
this has got that kind of flat thing to it, but that's got like, it's got a little bit of meat to it, but it's, like, for anyone who likes strats and wants, like, and is used to a modern C, because we're all used to a modern C now,
they've
been doing it for so long, that's not,
it's
not a 50s U-shaped neck, so it's, you know, don't be scared of it, it's comfortable, and especially with the narrow tall frets, it kind of plays off against it, so I think it's maybe a little bit of, you know, they're compensated by putting the narrow talls on there.
Yeah.
And it just, the perception of how it feels, doesn't feel thick.
Feels kind of a bit more rolled off on the edges as well. And the other thing is that this apparently has a new finish called Supernatural Finish on it, which does feel just like it's been played for yonks, basically. But it doesn't feel too different to that satin finish there. So, just a nice kind of satin finish. Is that it?
Bone nut, modern machine heads. Does this go bone nut on it?
Don't know, it didn't say.
Okay. Yeah. We got the specs from the Japanese Fender website, because these guitars aren't like readily available all the time. So, entertainment, read that direct translations, it's pretty good.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah, and that's kind of it. So, and then the hard case.
Hard case, yeah, hard shell case, which is pretty good.
Yeah.
So, I mean, what do you find is the difference? Like,
when I was listening to you play it before, I was listening to like the way that it was kind of breaking up in the high end, and this like sounds more controlled and kind of compressed to me than that one does. That one's got like a bit of a wiry kind of wildness in the high end, which is kind of good for some things. You know, this is maybe, you know, if you're playing in like a garage rock band or whatever, like that's a really great guitar for that, because you got that wildness to it. But if you're playing something that's a bit more clear and like precise, maybe this is a better thing to go for.
I think you said to me before, it could be a string gauge thing.
Yeah.
Because, you know, when you change from, say, 946s to 942s, you get a thinner sound.
Yeah.
So this... I don't know whether that is the thing with these two. They've probably got the same gauge strings on it. We probably should have learned that. But anyway, I was playing it before and it didn't feel different. This sounds thinner.
Yeah.
It's
more jangly as well.
Yeah, it's not, again, it's not a negative so much. It's just a different sound.
Yeah.
And the body feels lighter. So
yeah.
That feels like that's got more thickness to it.
Yeah.
So again, those two, for me, those things always add thickness and throatiness and tone. You know, more wood. That kind of more string resistance, you know, all that sort of stuff adds body.
Yeah.
And this just feels thinner in tone.
Yeah.
Saying that, there's no, for me, there's no playability difference.
Yeah.
Like, absolutely, these both are great guitars.
Yeah.
Like, it's pretty perfect. So I didn't find any, it's not easier to play that guitar than this guitar. You know, so if you like strats and you want to hot rod the crap out of something, but you want a really good one, you know, that one, I don't think you need to do much to that if you want a strat. It's pretty good.
Yep.
This, you know, if you're like heavier gauge strings and you're going to change the pickups to have like a humbucker in here or something like that.
Yeah.
This is going to provide all of the same basic stuff that's got.
Yep.
And then you can tweak it if you wanted to. But otherwise it's just
cash for tweaking. Yeah.
Yeah. Otherwise it's just, I mean, like, it's still a great strat. So don't get me wrong. Yeah. Like, It's on par. It's just tonally, I think that's better.
Well, let's test it out. Let's stick your mic in front of the amp and have a play.
Have a listen.
Here you go. Thank you.